When it came to recording and doing devotionals and writing and finding quiet time in the beginning of the day and in the middle of the day and now at the end of the day. And it's been a good day. It's been a time to catch up and to get things done. You know, with so little time left, you know, that sometimes I just want to kick back in a rocking chair and pretend like the world wasn't coming to an end and every day would be just the same. And stretch out to better and better. But unfortunately, that's not true. And we do live in the latter days. The earnest of our inheritance, from Ephesians 14. Oh, what enlightenment, what joys, what consolation, what delight of heart is experienced by that man who has learned to feed on Jesus and on Jesus alone. Yet the realization which we have of Christ's preciousness is, in this life, imperfect. As an old writer says, it's but a taste. We have tasted that the Lord is gracious, but we do not yet know how good and how gracious He is. Although we may know of His sweetness, He makes us although we may know of His sweetness, He makes us long for more. We have enjoyed the first fruits of the Spirit, and they have set us hungering and thirsting for the fullness of the heavenly vintage. We groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption. Here we are like Israel in the wilderness, who had but one cluster from Eshcol, there which shall be in the vineyard. Here we see the manna falling small like coriander seed, but there shall we eat the bread of heaven and old corn for the kingdom. We are but beginners now in spiritual education, for although we have learned the first letters of the alphabet, we cannot read the words. Yet much less can we put sentences together. But as one says, he that has been in heaven but 5 minutes knows more than the general assembly of all the divine on earth. We have many ungratiated desires at present, but soon every wish shall be satisfied and all our powers shall be filled. Find the sweetness, employment in that eternal world of joy. O Christian, antedate heaven for a few years. Within a very little time you shall be rid of all your trials and all your troubles. Your eyes now suffused with tears shall weep no longer. Thou shalt gaze in ineffable rapture upon the splendor of Him who sits upon the throne. Nay, more than that, upon His throne shalt thou sit. The triumph of His glory shall be shared by you, and His crown and His joy and His paradise shall be yours included. And thou shalt be co-heir with Him who is the heir of all things. People often look forward to what they already know, while I long for a place that I have not been, and yearn for a person I have not seen, to become home to a place that I know only that has been spoken of, and yet my heart knows that this place that I live now has never been my own. So I pray that, like me, you will find that the more you discover and realize Jesus in your life, the less you'll feel attached to the things of this world, and that you'll begin to look forward to walking away from it and leaving it all far, far behind. You're just passing through. This was never meant to be your home.